Hi, in this video, I'm going to explain about Chapter 9, Sequences and Series, Exercise 9.3, Question Number 5, in that A, B, C and Question Number 6 Solution. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. Question Number 5, which terms of the following sequences? See here, they have given the sequences. We need to find out the term, that is which term, that is the n value we need to find out here. So the first sequence is 2, 2 square root of 2, 4, that is the last term is here 128. So this is a geometric progression, and in the case of geometric progression, to find the nth term, the formula is an is equal to arn minus 1. Here a means the first term and r means the common ratio. So now let us find out, by using this sequence, we can find out the first term, that is a is equal to 2. Then here the last term they have given, that is an, that is equal to 128. Then r value, common ratio, we can find out by dividing the second term and first term, or third term and second term. So now the second term is 2 square root of 2 divided by 2. So this 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Here we get the r value, that is square root of 2. So now here we know the value of a, an and r. Just substitute these values in this formula. An, that is 128, is equal to a is 2, 2 into r is square root of 2 to the power n minus 1. Then this square root of 2, see, we can write as square root of 2 is nothing but 2 to the power half. So that I am writing as 2 to the power half. Then here we have n minus 1 power. So I am writing this one as 2 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2. So here this 2 I am taking this side, so that 128 divided by 2 is equal to 2 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2. Here this becomes 164 is equal to 2 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2. This 64 we can write in terms of power of 2, that is 2 to the power 6 is equal to 2 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2. Now here you can see that the base values are same, so that we can equalize the power. That is n minus 1 divided by 2 is equal to 6. N minus 1 is equal to 2 into 6, that is equal to 12. So n is equal to, bring this to this side, so 12 plus 1, so n is equal to 13. So here we got n is equal to 13, so that is a 13 is 128, so the 13th term. We need to find out the term here, so n value is equal to 13. Next, in the fifth question, question B, again here also we need to find out the n value. They have given the sequence square root of 3, 3, 3 square root of 3, and the last term is 729. So here we have to use this formula, nth term, that is an is equal to a into r to the power n minus 1. Now here a is equal to, the first term is square root of 3, so a is equal to square root of 3. The nth term is 729, so an is equal to 729, and r we can find out, that is 3 divided by square root of 3. See here in the denominator we have square root of 3, so that's why we have to rationalize. We can't leave the square root values in the denominator, so just rationalize this one. So you have to multiply this with square root of 3 as well as this with square root of 3, so that we can eliminate here square root symbol in the denominator. So this become 3 into square root of 3, this become 3 into 3, that is square root of 9, and square root of 9 value we know that is 3, so 3 square root of 3 divided by 3, so this and this will get cancelled, so here we have square root of 3, so r is equal to 3. Now substitute all these values in this formula, an is equal to arn minus 1, that is an is 729 is equal to a is square root of 3, then r is square root of 3 to the power then n minus 1. So 729 is equal to square root of 3 to the power, see here the base values are same, that means we can add the power 1 plus n minus 1. I am adding this power with this one. So here minus 1 and 1 will get cancelled. So here we have square root of 3 to the power n, and this is 3 to the power 6. Then square root of 3 is nothing but square root of 3, we can write as 3 to the power half. Then here we have this again n, so we can write this one as 3 to the power n divided by 2. So this is 3 to the power n divided by 2. Now again you can see that here base values are same, that means we can equalize the power values. So n by 2 is equal to 6, n is equal to 6 into 2, that is equal to 12. So the 12th term. Next year, we will see question number, that is C of fifth question. The 1 by 3, comma 1 by 9, comma 1 by 27, the nth term is 1 by 19683. Again, here also, we have to use same formula. So here, A is equal to 1 by 3, An is equal to 1 divided by 19683, and R value, we can find out 1 divided by 9 divided by 1 by 3. So here this become 1 by 9 into, this will go to the numerator, 3 by 1, 3 1s are, 3 3s are, so that is equal to 1 by 3. So we know these values, just substitute these values in this formula, An is equal to 1 by 19683, that is equal to, A is equal to 1 by 3 into, R is equal to 1 by 3, so 1 by 3 to the power n minus 1. Now here, see here, this 3 you can bring to this side so that this will come in the numerator here. So 3 divided by 19683, that is equal to 1 by 3 to the power n minus 1. So if you divide this with this, then we get here 1 divided by 6561, that is equal to 1 by 3 to the power n minus 1. This 6561 is nothing but 3 to the power 8. So 1 divided by 3 to the power 8 is equal to 1 by 3 to the power n minus 1. This we can write as 1 to the power 8 is 1 only. So 1 divided by 3 to the power 8 is equal to 1 divided by 3 to the power n minus 1. Now here base values are same. That means you can equalize the power values. So n minus 1 is equal to 8. N is equal to 8 plus 1. That is n is equal to 9. So that is the 9th term. Next here, question number 6. For odd values of x, the numbers minus 2 divided by 7, x, comma minus 7 by 2 are in GP. So here we need to find out for what values of x. So we need to find out the x value so that we need to see that whether the numbers are in geometric progression or not. See here, they have given three numbers. Now here, minus 2 divided by 7, then comma x, comma minus 7 divided by 2. This is there in GP. This is given in the question. And see, there is a formula that is the known as the geometric mean. Geometric mean, suppose if you have three numbers, let us say that A, B, C, and if these A, B, C are in geometric progression, then we can write that one as B square is equal to AC. Or we can write B is equal to square root of AC. This is known as a geometric mean. So this one, now we have to use here. So that is B is equal to square root of AC. So now here, see, they have given these values here. So first here, from this we can get A is equal to minus 2 divided by 7. Next here, if you compare these three terms with this one, then here we can say that B is equal to X, A is equal to minus 2 divided by 7, then B is equal to X and C is equal to minus 7 divided by 2. Now here, see, if there are three terms in the GP, then we can write that one as in this form, that is B square is equal to AC. This is the known. So we will write now this particular value in this form only. See, B is equal to X here, so X square is equal to A. A is minus 2 divided by 7 into C is minus 7 divided by 2. So here you can cancel the value and here we get 1. So X square is equal to 1. That means X is equal to plus or minus 1. So for the X value here, we have to find out because they have given that this is there in the GP. So for what values of X they have asked. So the X value is plus or minus 1. See here, I have not used any nth term formula. Instead of that, I have used geometric mean, that is B is equal to square root of AC. This we get if we have three terms in GP, then we can write like this way, B square is equal to AC, that is nothing but B is equal to square root of AC. This we get like suppose, let us say that generally when we find the common ratio, we write second term divided by first term, that is B divided by A. Then that is equal to third term divided by second term, that is C divided by B. This we know, that is nothing but the common ratio. So here, if you multiply, we get B square, that is equal to AC. So B is equal to square root of AC, which is nothing but the geometric mean. So this value, I compared with this one and then I got the value, that is X is equal to plus or minus 1. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon for regular notification. Thanks for watching.